Welcome back to the channel. I'm gonna go straight to the point. Is there something wrong with the scale of Sweden's solar system, the world's biggest scale model of our solar system? According to a few comments to my last videos, the answer is yes. But is there, really? In this video, I'll tell you all about the problem with Sweden's solar system. And in order to understand better, we have to go way back to the Big Bang. No, not quite, but to the 90s. It's also a long time ago by now. It was the mid-90s and two professors started to draw up a giant scale model of the inner planets, inspired by the existence of Stockholm's huge spherical globe arena. They wanted to call it the Stockholm Solar System and orient the planetary lineup towards the north, since they would then fall in interesting places, such as the Stockholm Center for Astronomy and the Natural History Museum.
But wait a second. Are you saying the globe arena just happened to have exactly the right dimensions for this to coincide? Well, that's what we all assumed, right? In reality, this favorable placement of the planets could only happen after a small adjustment to the scale.
You see, the globe arena measures 110 meters in diameter, which probably seemed too big of a scale for the solar system model. The professors settled instead on a scale of 1 to 20 million, which gives a sun of 71 meters. In conclusion, if the globe arena represents the sun's photosphere, the scale of Sweden's solar system is 36% smaller than it should be. Let's have a look at the consequences of this adjustment. Planets are located at well-visited spots, like the Natural History Museum. Models are more affordable to build and easier to accommodate. Traveling is shortened between models, making a road trip more practical. The Sweden solar system, including the termination shock, actually fits in Sweden.
Well, what do you think about this trade-off? Was it worth it? Or what would you have done differently? Let me know in the comments. And of course, hit the like button, and I'll see you in the next video.